In this video, we're going to finish out the review of algebraic and numeric expressions. This is a free worksheet provided by Kuta software under the Infinite Algebra 2 tab. You can find this worksheet within the basics section. And for this last bit, we're going to be focusing on simplifying algebraic expressions. So let's get started with number 19. In number 19, we have 9x plus 9 minus 1. What we're going to do is combine like terms. There's only one term with the variable x. However, there are two numbers that we can combine. That is 9 and 1. So we'll have 9x plus 9 minus 1, which is 8. And that's our solution for number 19. In number 20, we have 10n minus 4n. Since both of those have a single n, they can be combined together. So 10n minus 4n will leave us with 6n. You can think of this 10 times n as n plus n 10 times. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 n's. And we're subtracting 4 n's, so taking away 4 of those. 1, 2, 3, 4. That leaves us with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 n. Number 21, we're going to have to distribute. However, I'm going to convert this and add a negative 6 as opposed to subtracting a positive 6. So I'm going to distribute this negative 6 to the negative v and then to a 5 with addition in between. So I'll have negative 9 plus negative 6 times negative v plus negative 6 times 5. So I'll have negative 9 plus negative 6 times negative v will result in a positive 6v, and we're adding negative 6 times 5, which is negative 30. Now I can combine negative 9 with negative 30 to get negative 39, and we're still adding 6v to that. So negative 39 plus 6v is my solution in number 21. In number 22, I'm going to distribute the negative 10. I'll multiply negative 10 by negative 8x and by positive 9, and there's addition between those two terms. So I'll have negative 10 times negative 8x plus negative 10 times a positive 9 minus 8x. So I'll go ahead and multiply negative 10 by negative 8x, and at the same time, I'll multiply negative 10 by 9, since we have to do multiplication before we do addition or subtraction. So negative 10 times negative 8 is going to be a positive 80x, and we're adding that to negative 10 times 9, which is negative 90, and we're still subtracting or taking away 8x. Now combining like terms, we can combine 80x with 8x. However, this 8x is subtracted, so you can think of it as adding a negative 8x. 80x minus 8x is going to be 72x. And we're still subtracting or adding that negative 90. 72x minus 90 is the solution in number 22. In number 23, I'm going to have to distribute the 4. I'll multiply it to 2, and I'll multiply it to 3k. However, there's subtraction in between those two terms. So I'll have 1 plus 4 times 2 minus 4 times 3k. So I'll have 1 plus 4 times 2, which is 8, minus 4 times 3k, which will be 12k. Next, I can combine my 1 and 8 to get 1 plus 8 is equal to 9, and we're subtracting 12k from that. 9 minus 12k is my answer in number 23. Number 24, I'm distributing the 6. 6 gets multiplied to 10, and it gets multiplied to 6v, with addition in between. So I'll have negative 8v plus 6 times 10 plus 6 times 6v. Negative 8v plus 6 times 10 is 60 plus 6 times 6 times v is 36 times v, which is 36v. I'll combine negative 8v with a positive 36v to get negative 8v plus 36v, which will be a 28v, and I'm still adding 60 to that. 28v plus 60. And number 25, I'm going to distribute this 7 with addition in between, and I'm going to add this negative 8 as opposed to subtracting a positive 8. So now I'm going to be distributing a negative 8 with subtraction in between. 7 times 1 is 7, plus 7 times 9v will be 63v. We're adding that to negative 8 times negative 5v, which is a positive 40v, and we're subtracting negative 8 times 6, which is negative 48. Now I'm going to combine 63v and 40v together. So I'll get 7 plus 63v plus 40v is 103v. And subtracting a negative 48 is the same as adding a positive 48. Now I'll combine 7 and 48. 7 plus 48 will be 55. So my final solution will be 55 plus 103v. I'll go ahead and convert everything to addition. So I'm going to convert this to adding a negative 7, and this is also going to be adding a negative 7. So I'll distribute this negative 10 to both the x and negative 7 with addition in between now, and I'll distribute this negative 7 to x and 2 with addition in between. Negative 10 times x is negative 10x, plus negative 10 times negative 7 is a positive 70. And then I'm adding negative 7 times x, which is negative 7x, plus negative 7 times 2 is negative 14. So I'm going to combine 70 and negative 14 together, and at the same time, I'm going to combine negative 10x and negative 7x together. Negative 10x plus negative 7x results in a negative 17x. And we're adding that to 70 plus a negative 14, so 70 minus 14, which is 56. So my simplified expression in number 26 is negative 17x plus 56. In number 27, I'll go ahead and distribute. I have subtraction in between those two terms, and I have addition in between those two terms. However, we have to note that we're subtracting this entire quantity. So negative 2 times negative 6x is a positive 12x. And we're subtracting negative 2 times 9, which is going to be a negative 18. Then we're subtracting 4 times x, which is 4x, and 4 times 9, which is 36. Now I had to leave these within parentheses because since we're subtracting this entire quantity, we're subtracting 4x plus 36. So we'll have 12x minus a negative 18 is the same as adding a positive 18, minus 4x minus 36. Because allowing this to remain subtraction, you can think of this as adding the opposite of what's in these parentheses. So this will be a negative 4x, so we'll be taking away 4x, and we'll be taking away 36. That's why usually at the beginning, whenever I distribute a number that's subtracted, I like to change it to adding a negative and then distributing that negative number. However, I just wanted to show you that it is not necessary to convert everything to addition. In my opinion, it's a lot simpler. But let's go ahead and finish working through this expression. What I want to do is combine my 12x and take away that 4x since we're subtracting 4x, and combine this 18 with this 36. However, we're also taking away that 36 since it's subtracted. So 12x minus 4x, or plus a negative 4x, will leave me with 8x. And I have 18 and I'm taking away or subtracting 36, so that will leave me with a negative 18. So I'll still be subtracting 18 at the end. So 27, our solution is 8x minus 18. And lastly, on to number 28. I'm distributing 9, and I'm going to distribute 3. There's addition between these two terms and subtraction between these. 9 times 7k is 63k, and I'm adding that to 9 times 8, which is 72. That gets added to 3 times k, which is 3k, minus 3 times 10, which is 30. Now, combining like terms, I'll combine 72 and take away 30 from that, since subtracting 30 is the same as adding a negative, and I'll also combine 63k with 3k. 63k plus 3k is 66k, and I'm adding that to 72 minus 30, which is 42. So my final solution for this worksheet is 66k plus 42. And go ahead and give me a thumbs up if you found this video helpful. And also don't forget to click that subscribe button. All likes and subscriptions are greatly appreciated. Also, if you're still confused on any part of this worksheet, leave a comment below and I'll get back to you as soon as I can.